Let's take Blender 3D print design to the next level and create a print-in-place geared fidget toy. So here we go. I have 10 minutes on the clock. I'll be surprised if I do this in 10, but I'm going to go my full speed. 3, 2, 1, go. Right, so I already have an idea of what I'm going to be creating here, and I'm going to be using the power of precision gears. So if you want to find out more about that, it's all going to be linked down in the description. So let's just go here. Let's make this fit to the gear that I'm wanting to. I'm going to start with 15. I'm going to go with a module of 3, a height of 15 sounds good to me. I want to be the shift of 0. Clearance, let's go with a helix angle. I'm going to go pretty hard on this. I'm going to go with 45. Let's do an undercut and turn that into a herringbone. But I'm not too happy with these sharp corners here, so I'm going to actually add a tooth modification as well. Let's go for a tip relief. I think at 0.9 is what works nice at this one. Yeah, and then I'm going to go with a relief of, let's say, 5. So here we have it. That is some pretty decent mesh that's going on there. Okay, now let's add a bore hole in there. So let's go down, bore. Here we have it. Let's make that a polygon. Let's set the resolution to 100. Let's go with what? What's the minimum I want to go with? 12? Is that about what I want? Yeah, 12, because then that makes it nice and 24. That lets me have my finger, my thumb in there more than anything. Okay, now that we have that in place there, let's create the other one. So Shift D on the Y, pull that out here. I'm going to do the helix angle this time on the minus, so minus 45. And let's increase the teeth to 20, so it's something nice and big. And let's also go to the hole here. Let's make this, what, 22? So that 22 is a bit too much, maybe. I think that's all right, actually. Yeah, I'm quite happy with that. Maybe I'll go with 21 instead. Yeah, okay. Now that we've done that, let's just take a look here. I am working on a way that this is going to work procedurally, so we don't have to sort of do this by eye. But for now, let's just go do this by eye like that. Now, when it comes to the tolerances, I'm going to have an entire video of tolerances, again, linked in the description. But I'm going to make this a nice big tolerance of 0.6 so that this will work on anybody's 3D printer. Okay, now that we have that in place and I'm quite happy with how these gears are going to turn out, it's time to do a little bit of finessing to these gears. I'm going to take this into edit mode. I'm going to do circle selection of all of this center vertices right here, because one of the caveats is right this minute those are not joining correctly. So I'm going to just create a vertex group. In that vertex group, assign that, deselect it, select it to double check it. Brilliant. Now that I've done that, I'm going to go and add a modifier, another weld modifier, to the vertex group that I just did, so you can see what exactly is going to happen here. You can see those aren't joined up, so that vertex group connected. I think it was 0.3 should connect those up. Nope, maybe 0.4. Nope, 0.5. Surely that would connect that up. Why is that not connecting those up? Oh, wait, I'm silly. There we go. So maybe 0.3 did connect that up. So 0.3. Yeah, that is much better. I might be able to get away with less, but I'm going to stay with that because time is tight. So let's go and do the same with the other one here. We'll do X-ray, circle selection, increase our selection circle to all of that there. Create that vertex group here, assign that, deselect it, select it to double check it, go back out. Go and get that weld modifier going here over to that vertex group. Let's go 0.3. Gonna go with connected. Quickly check that and edit. Make sure that we turn on edit mode checking. And I think that looks pretty clean to me indeed. Best way to do this is to just apply these and test it. So let's apply that there. Go in here, face selection, said, yep, that works perfectly. Go over to this one, apply this one here into edit mode, check by selecting that one, that works perfectly. Okay, now I'm going to add a loop cut down in here. And now, because that's already selected, I'm going to go and remove that from here. So now with that removed, again, we're going to deselect everything and then select it to double check it. That's working good there. And the reason why I'm doing this is I'm about to add a bevel. So let's do that once again. We've got a loop cut right there. We're going to Then go to the vertex group here. We're going to remove that there. AA to deselect, select it up. That's looking good. Perfect. So that means I can now go into here and add a bevel modifier and use the vertex group once again. Let's aim for what? 4, I think, is a good one. We'll go here. Is 4 too much? Probably is. Let's go for 3 then. Okay, now that we have that there, let's do the same to this one here. So we'll add that bevel. Assign that to the vertex group. We're going to go this vertex group here, go by 3. I think that is as good as we're going to get right now. I might actually make this one 4. And if that's going to be 4, yeah, I think that works much better. That looks good right there. Okay, so we've got that there, that there. I'm happy with that. So I'm going to sort of just bake this all down. So I'm applying all that there. I'm applying all that there. We're going to now select both of these, go into edit mode here, go face selection, loop selection of all these faces now. So all of this here, I missed one face there, and loop selection there. Press Shift D, and then it's going to be parting by selection. Brilliant. So now I have these things right here. So here I'm going to quickly set that rotation back to the 0 there. Select these, both of them, that and that, into edit mode, select it all up. Now I'm going to do Alt S, and I'm doing the 3D printing offset at this point, which I'm going to go for 0.5, I think, and make sure that I hit S, so up at the top it's even thickness. Now that I've done that, let's press Shift D to duplicate that, Alt S, S once again for even thickness. I'm going to go with 2 millimeters this time, and that is good right there. Let's go edge selection now, and I'm going to select all this edge, all that edge. I have my quick menu with bridge edge loops. Remember, that is underneath the edge menu right there. And then I'm going to go and select this one, bridge edge loops there, and we'll do the same over here. So bridge this and there. So cube bridge edge loops. And once again, we've got this one here and that one there, cube bridge edge loops. That's all good. Let's quickly check our normals there. Look, it's gone red in there. So that's not quite right. Select everything, Shift N. Okay, normals are sorted. That is sorted, but that is not very print in place. So let's sort that out. So let's bring in a plane, make that plane nice and big. I'm gonna go for 150. Move this G over to there. Yep, edit mode, extrude that by 10 in the other direction. Select it all, Shift N to make those work properly now. And let's go into our quick selection, not quick selection, snapping menu there, because we're wanting to snap this to there. Brilliant. Okay, so now that we've done that there, let's select this, select that, go, let's join these two up into one object. So Control J, U, Control Shift minus, U have now been cut up, and that is good. Now there's a little bit of a caveat here, which is when it comes to print in place, you don't want to start an angle and start an angle. I don't know why, it just doesn't work. So what we've got to do is a little bit of extra little work here. And you know what, I'm going to actually do that before that lovely little cut that we did here. Wait, let me just bring back everything. Yes, that cube is there. Brilliant. So I can go into here, local view these, and this is why, because I want to basically grab these. I'm going to grab this face, I'm going to extrude those down, and then I'm going to loop select this, loop select that, go GZ1 upwards. And now that we've done that, we can do our loop cut, our boolean here, does that boolean there. And now we have to select both of our gears here, and we have to local view these, take these into edit mode, and we have to sort this out here. So we're going to select all of those faces there, select all of those faces there. Then I'm going to extrude these up by 1 millimeter. Now that's going to create some broken geometry right here. So we have to select the edge loop here. We have to select the edge loop, not that one, but this one here. A little bit of accurate selection, Jonathan, please. We do not need that. There, yeah, GZ, we're going to go by 2, bring that up to there. That is looking good. Just for the sake of it, I'm going to select it all, press Shift N, just to make sure everything is good. So that is that. Now we have to join these two together. I only have 40 seconds left. I don't know if I'm going to be able to do it. So let's see. I'm going to select all of that, extrude this up. And I've screwed that up, I think. So Z0, Z on the 0, brilliant. And now I'm going to bring this down. So GZ down to right there, select it all, merge by distance. Now I just need to select some faces quickly, select those faces there. And we're going to select these faces here, go bridge edge loops. Oh, I'm not going to get this in time. I need to go with edge, press J on that. Oh, this is, oh, not there, but I am so close. So let's just quickly sort out what I've got to do correctly here. So if I undo that, I have that selected. What it is an X, a limited dissolve to simplify that down right there. Now, once that's been simplified down, I just need to select the edges right here. So we'll dissolve that edge here. Then we can do a vertex selection between these and define that with a J. And that should do it. Oh, there's an extra edge right there that shouldn't be there. So let's dissolve that edge. That's how it should be. Now I can select those two right there, join that with a J. Let's just quickly, just for the sake of seeing things properly, let's local view this here. Then let's take it into edit mode. So there we have it. This is almost okay, but not quite. So let's limited dissolve there, and let's limit dissolve that right here. That is correct, but this shouldn't really be here. I don't think we need this geometry here. We don't need you right there, but what we do need is an edge between both of you there, and we go that. So from here there to there, we're going to go J. That is it. That is it completely. So I'm just going to select you. We don't need you. Let's select everything, merge by distance, set that to a decent 0.1, I think would be maybe a little bit too much, but I'm going to do it because look, that removes 65, and I have a feeling that's right along there. So that there, if we go out, is our lovely 3D print in place, gears done that quickly. So let's quickly do a 3D print check, as we should always do. So here we have it, 3D print. We're going to check this one here. That is looking all good. We have some non-flat faces, but that's totally fine. I'm sure it's talking about these right here. And let's see this gear right here. And that gear is perfect. There's a couple of thin faces. I can expect why that would be. And also here, let's do a nice little check. That is all perfectly ready for 3D printing. Let's go and chuck this into a slicer quickly and then get it printed. So let's go file export STL. And here we have it in Prusa Slicer. It looks like it's going to print out absolutely perfectly. So let's go and set this off to print. And there you have it. I'm really loving the design. I didn't realize I would enjoy this fidget thing so much. There is one little thing though, a little bit too much give for my liking. So I took this back into Blender. I selected these faces right here and extruded them out by about a millimeter and a half. And then I reprinted it here, has much less of a give, and it still spins just as great. Now, the key thing for this to spin so fluidly like that is by using a little bit of silicone grease and then just work at it, and then eventually it just goes perfectly. Now, I did use Precision Gears, my add-on, to do this, and you can just get the free version and do this with spur gears. Now, I do have a spur gear one right here, but this does have undercuts on it, and that is part of the full Precision Gear set. Now, I am planning to add a whole bunch more to Precision Gears, including timing belts and much more. The next update is going to be doing rigging, so you'll actually be able to animate this in Blender really quickly and easily. But yeah, just letting you know about that. So if you found this way too overwhelming and there's too much information, and you might have thought that I was using custom shortcuts or something else, don't worry. All of this is explained through my entire free course down in the description. Or if you're wanting to learn Blender for 3D printing through 3D printing projects, I also have a paid course that is linked down in the description that is a very quick start kickstart guide that will get you making things in Blender for 3D printing in no time. A huge thank you to my patrons. You guys are absolutely awesome, and without you, I would have not been able to make Maker Tales. Really means the world to me, and a huge thank you to my VIP maker, Jem Oskinak. If you like what I'm doing here and you think I'm worthy of your support, I would love to see you there too. And don't forget that we have a Discord, and that is linked down in the description. Thank you for watching, keep making, and let the quest continue. I wonder how fast I can make something like this go.